All right, as you can see, we got a big bull down. Just want to let you guys know it's very possible, it's very doable to take a bull like this on public ground. This is a national forest over-the-counter unit in North Idaho. Anybody can hunt here, anybody that's willing to do the work. I prefer not to hunt with an outfitter. I got nothing against outfitters, but I take a lot of pride in being able to get on my dirt bike, go into the backcountry, get off of it in pitch black, hike in 3, 4, 5, whatever miles, gain vertical, drop in on these huge bulls in the public ground. These bulls get hunted real hard. You're gonna have to deal with a lot of hunting pressure. When I shot this bull this morning today, I had to drive by 3 or 4 rigs to get to this spot, and you can't be discouraged they're here. Another thing that to mention is physical conditioning is probably the most important piece of equipment you can own, your body. So you got to take care of it, because this is what's going to get you up and down the mountains. This is day 5 of a 6-day hunt, and I bet I could count under 20 hours of sleep total for the past 5 days. I want to take you guys through a day in the life of a public land, do-it-yourself bow hunter. That's me by definition. Yeah, so, number one, I hunt with my dad. He's 54 years old, so I have to make sure that he's fit. So he's a member of our CrossFit box, works out 4 times a week, and his only motivation is to keep up with me in the fall. Love it, and he does his job. He stays fit year-round. 3 a.m., because it's early September, alarm goes off, time to get up. Slam down a breakfast, get a 20 to 30 pound pack on your back that's gonna have enough supplies to not only feed you for the whole day, but all the what if scenarios. You know, what if we get weathered in? What if somebody gets hurt? First aid kit. What if we kill an animal? Do we have the game bags to recover the meat? A lot of what ifs, so the pack's pretty heavy. Now where I hunt for elk, we get there via dirt bike. So you're in the dark, you fire up that dirt bike, and it's single track. And it's 5 to 10 miles to get way back. Kill the bike, now you're in the backcountry, but now you gotta go further. So 2 to 3 mile hike, it's just starting to get light and you're waiting for to hear an elk bugle, okay? Let's say that you hear an elk bugle, but it's way down in that hole. You gotta drop 2,000 vertical feet with your pack on, with your bow. You get down there. Let's just say God's fortunate enough to smile upon you and you're lucky and you harvest an elk. Great, congratulations. You just harvested an 800 pound animal and you're 15 miles as the crow flies from civilization. So what are you gonna do? You're gonna clean that elk out. For those who don't know, that means, you know.
Gut him out.
Gut it out. You're gonna go ahead and be the butcher. You know, you're not relying on Albertsons to do your butchering, you are the butcher. So you gotta know the cuts of meat. You gotta know how to salvage all the edible meat, because that's going in your freezer and your wife is dependent on you to get that meat because she likes not having to buy meat. And you gotta get that meat hanging in a tree so it stays cool and that no bugs or predators get to it. And then all of a sudden the clock started. 3, 2, 1, go. It's time to get that meat off the mountain. So you and your dad, you both load up 100 pounds because that's about what a guy can carry. I don't care how tough you are, you can carry about 100 pounds. Okay, so you and your dad split up 100 pounds and you work your way up out of that hole. You get on your dirt bike, you ride all the way back down to the truck, get that meat on ice, and then you do it all over again. You get back up in there. It may take 24 to 36 hours. As long as your meat is cool or by a creek and doesn't get disturbed by a bear or some other predator, that meat's there and you can get it out. Once you get that meat, you're gonna hang it. You're gonna hang it for anywhere between 3 to 8 days, depending on who you are and what your taste is. We hang our meat for 3 or 4 days. And then we do all the butchering. So we grind our own meat, we make our ground burger, we bag it up, we freeze it, we also cut our own steaks. And fortunately, an elk will last us at least 8 months. And that is meat that is not immunized, doesn't have hormones added to it. It is the most precious, perfected protein source on this planet, and we're fortunate enough to consume it.
Absolutely.